understand just why we praise. Let me tell you how it all went down. The news spread so very fast. People came from miles around.
You didn't read up on the wrong brother, Pastor Mike.
You know, let me ask you a question. Who was the king that came over with the Israelites from Africa?
The Lord will bring you and your king, whom you said, oh,
you
and
who?
The Lord will bring you and your king, whom he said, over you, to a nation that neither you nor your fathers have known.
Who was your king in Africa?
Who was the king?
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 And I'm looking here and there, searching everywhere.
If y'all stay behind my man, we stay behind my man. We are Christians. We want to be in order and respectful.
That's right.
We gonna go there with the text. Don't worry about a thing.
Okay.
So you can ask me a question.
Yeah.
Then I'll ask you a question.
I'm gonna tell you straight.
That's how it's going down.
Look, turn your speaker that way, so it's no more preaching. Can we hear that?
That's okay, y'all.
Cool. All right, you ready? Why is it that you feel it's okay to keep the not to keep the commandments of God?
We keep the commandments of Christ. Case closed. My turn.
So
when we bear one another's burdens, we fulfill the whole law of Christ. Y'all stuck at Sinai. We at the cross.
Amen. Come on. You niggas don't love God. Y'all don't keep the commandments. My man's got a shaved face right now. My man's got a bald head. None of y'all got friends on y'all. Y'all don't love God. Y'all hate God. Y'all don't know God. Let me find John chapter 3. Romans chapter 3.
listen, but listen, y'all. Hold on. Hold on, y'all. Y'all, we gonna keep this peaceful.
Listen good.
Y'all don't think?
Romans chapter 3 verse 1. Hey, I'm gonna tell you straight.
Let's keep it peaceful.
We ain't the Christian church. No, you ain't dealing with no cool fans. You came to our congregation with our children, with our wives. So I'm going to tell you straight. If you want to lead peaceful, you better act peaceful. Read what you got. Romans chapter 3, verse 1. What is finished, then you have the truth.
We out here on the east side, middle of the hood. About to start this blitz. You know what I'm saying? About to start this blitz. Marvin Winans Church, they told us they was gonna have a sit down with us. They ducked us, so now we back. These brothers here, we gonna deal with it.
And 3 7 days, reason with them out of the scripture.
We're here to reason with you.
That's right.
Let's talk about love.
You came to our congregation with our children, with our wives. You came to our congregation with our children, with our wives. You came to our congregation with our children, with our wives. You came to our congregation with our children, with our wives. You want to have a conversation?
Can I hold on? I'll speak. Everybody silent on my side.
Absolutely. If you answer yes or no, you can speak. Do you want to have a conversation?
We don't need your permission.
Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Everybody, hold on. Hold on. We can have a conversation, but y'all looking like y'all want something else. Yeah. Now, we prepared for anything, but we are Christians. We don't want it to go like that. Right. Trust me, I'm too old to be out here fighting.
Yeah, I know that feels bad.
It ain't gonna be that.
You have been fighting a long time. I'm gonna tell you straight.
I didn't fight when I did.
Yeah.
So hold
my
on.
My question was, do you want to have a conversation?
Hold on.
Did you get carnal now?
Let me answer.
Do you want to have a conversation?
We can have a respectful conversation, but y'all seem to want something else.
Now, can I answer that?
Go right ahead.
I don't want to have a conversation. You came to our place. You show up at our, you set up at our place where we congregate, and you came for war. When we show up to church, we come to kill them. If they say they want to have a sit down, we leave. Now listen, we're still talking. You want to have a conversation? We don't want to talk about shit.
Right.
We ain't conversation with nothing. We ain't gonna give y'all nothing but thus says the Lord. Ain't no conversation when you walk up on the Israelites.
Stay away from the church.
Nos gusta brincar. Yes, we like to jump. Muy caliente, very hot. Now it's time to jump. Brinca. Here we go. Are you still jumping?
Hey, they don't want to have no conversation because this man, they got a young fella up here. He don't know no Bible. All he got is attitude.
Are we having a conversation?
He and make his face shine on us so that your ways may be known on earth. Your salvation among all nations. See, they think Israel the only nation that could be saved. And the truth of the matter is, ain't none of them Israel. They all Hamites. They all Hamites. They think they Israel, but they not. And then they saying salvation is only for Israel. They think salvation is only for Israel, but it's not. It's for all nations. Again, they don't want the truth. They don't want the truth. They wanted a fight. They wanted to be aggressive. Now, we didn't come to fight. We still know how to fight, but we didn't come to fight, right? We left because we don't want to do that. We're Christians. We are orderly. We do things decently and in order. But they don't want it. They don't want the truth. They want aggressiveness. They don't want the word of God. They want to lie to one another. They're lying to all our young black men. Yep. They're pulling people out of the church who don't know the Bible. That's all. People who don't know the Bible. Those are the people that they're pulling out the church. Give me a water, somebody. All they wanted was to make noise because they know the last time it didn't go good for them.
Yeah.
And we got all kind of clips. They said, yeah, we better not go back and forth with these brothers. Even the other Israelite camps, IUIC and the rest of them said them urban apologists put the work on these boys. They don't want scripture. They don't want the word of God. Oh yeah, they fired my man from last time. They're not letting him speak to us no more. They say no. They got him standing on the pole right now. They said, don't you move. Right? Hey, somebody give me Galatians chapter 3. Give me Galatians chapter 3. We might as well give some word out here. They didn't want the word, but we might as well give some word out here. They're not giving no word. They don't want to. They mad because we showed up. They said we shouldn't have showed up. They showing up at churches every week spewing this poison, but now they saying we shouldn't have showed up. Stop showing up at the churches, and we'll stop showing up here.
That's right.
Give me verse number 8.
And trust in oppression.
In the scripture. In the scripture, foreseeing that God would justify the Gentiles by faith, preached the gospel beforehand to Abraham, saying, in you shall all the nations be blessed.
So it says, foreseeing in the scriptures that God would justify the Gentiles. The Gentiles. So the gospel was preached before in Genesis that God would justify the Gentiles, saying in Abraham, in you all the nations of the world will be blessed. All the nations of the world will be blessed. But they don't want that. Read on some more. Read verse 9.
So then those who are of faith are blessed along with Abraham, the man of faith.
So wait a minute. Those who are of what?
Of faith.
Those who are of faith are blessed right along with Abraham. So we know that the true children of God is not by ethnicity. The true children of God are a people of God by faith. Faith in God alone. But they don't have no faith. They have faith in themselves. They have faith in their color. They have faith in their ethnicity. But we have faith in Christ. When you put your faith in Christ, God promised that he will save you. Come on, read on some more here.
For all who rely on the works of the law are under a curse, for it is written, cursed be everyone who does not abide by all things written in the book of the law and do them.
Now notice what it says. All those who depend on the law are still under the curse. Whether these brothers realize it or not, they're putting themselves under the curse. They're putting themselves under the curse. The reason they're putting themselves under the curse is because nobody fulfills the law. They're not keeping the law. They're not keeping the law. They're not even close to keeping the law. And if they're not keeping the whole law, you're under the curse. But they say that they're keeping the law. They're not keeping no law. They're not keeping no law at all. Right? Read on just a little bit more.
Now it is evident that no one is justified before God by the law, for the righteous shall live by faith.
No one is justified by the law.
Are you righteous?
Again, we are righteous by faith. How are we righteous? How are we righteous? By faith. How are we righteous? By faith. How are we righteous? By faith. Oh, they don't understand that. He thinks he can curse, act belligerent, and think he's keeping the law. Because he don't want the work. He don't want it. They didn't want the scriptures. All right, read on a little bit more. Let's check out Paul in Galatians.
But the law is not of faith. Rather, the one who does them shall live by them. Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us. It is written, curses everyone who is hanged on a tree.
All right, Christ has done what? He has redeemed us from the curse of the law. See, they're still under the curse because they're still saying that one is obligated to keep it.
They're under the curse.
But Christ delivered us from the curse of the law when he was hung up on the tree on our behalf. But they don't understand that. They don't understand. Read on some more.
In Christ Jesus, the blessing of Abraham might come to the Gentiles so that we might receive the promised Spirit through faith.
Thank you. So now that the promise has come to the Gentiles, we receive the promised Spirit. How? By faith. How? By faith. So it's about faith. It's not about law. The law came by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. And so this is what we're about. We're about the truth. We're not trying to get into no physical altercation. They want a physical altercation. That's clear. That's evident. Right? They want to pull the old people out. But we don't want to do that. We want to see them saved. We love them brothers over there. Right now, if they don't repent, they're going to hell. But we want to see them saved. Right? We want to see them saved. But right now, they're preaching a false doctrine. They're preaching a false doctrine.
Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29. No foul language is to come from your mouth, but only what is good for building up someone in need so that it gives grace to those who hear.
Thank you. No foul language should come out of their mouth. Right? No foul language should come out of their mouth. But they don't understand that. Right? They want to continue to talk in foul language. They want to continue to lie to our people. They want to continue to do the wrong thing. They want to continue to act belligerent. But we want to stand on the truth of God's word. Because they don't want the truth. We left off from over there because we're not trying to get into a fight. We're not trying to come. We're not trying to get into a physical altercation, right? But they don't have the Spirit of God. They don't have the Spirit of God. So we have no problem with that. We about the truth.
My fear is just in God. That's why we.
Thank you. We fear God. We fear God and God alone. But they don't fear God. These men fear their Nathaniel. Nathaniel is their God. That's who they fear. They fear Nathaniel. Hey, come on, y'all. Y'all fear Nathaniel. 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 See, they don't fear God. They fear Nathaniel.
Nathaniel
has changed lives. That's good. Hey.
We got it.
Come on, y'all. Hey, listen up. Nathaniel is your God. 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 See, they worship. Hey, Esau. Esau. Hey, there go Esau. That's the white man is his king. Hey, who's the king, bro? Hey, bro. Who's the king?
Who's the king?
Who's the king? Hey, who's the king?
Who's the king?
Who is the king? Who's the king? Who's the king, young man?
Hey,
listen, give me Galatians chapter 4.
You shouldn't have made the decision to come out here.
Galatians chapter 4.
You told me that when I came in the car. You should have let this go, Mike, because you look bad on camera, Mike. You look bad on camera, Mike. No answers across the street.
Give me Galatians 4. Start around, let's see.
I came out of the car with y'all. You tell my life.
For this work be a man, it will come to
what says the law is our schoolmaster.
It will come to naught. It says this house will be a man. It's going to come to naught. But it may be of God to be a what? If it be of God, you cannot overdo it. That's why you came out here.
Yes, sir.
Because you can't overdo it.
Okay. Where's that? Hey, let me see that Bible for a minute. We're just gonna get a few more.